Κύριε ο Θεός, ο άμνος του Θεού, ο Υιός του Πατρός, ο αίρον την αμαρτίαν του κόσμου, ελέησον ημάς, ο αίρον τας αμαρτίας του κόσμου.
Πρόσδεξε την δέησιν ημών, ο καθήμενος εν δεξιά του Πατρός, και ελέησον ημάς.
Ο ετης ημώνας Άγιος, σοι ημώνας Κύριος, Ιησούς Χριστός, εις δόξαν Θεού Πατρός, αμήν.
Καθεκάστην ημέραν ευλογήσασε και ενέσω το όνομά σου εις τον αιώνα και εις τον αιώνα του αιώνα.
Καταξίωσον Κύριε, εν τη μέρα ταύτη, αναμαρτήτους φυλαχθήνε ημάς. Ευλογητός η Κύριε, ο Θεός των Πατέρων ημών, και ενετών και δεδοξασμένων, το όνομά σου εις τους αιώνας, αμήν.
Γέννητο Κύριε, το ελαιός σου εφημάς, καθά περιλπίσαμεν επίσε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδάξον με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδάξον με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδάξον με τα δικαιώματά σου. Κύριε, καταφυγή εγεννήθης ημίν, εν γενεά και γενεά, εγώ είπα Κύριε, ελέησον με, ίασε την ψυχή μου, ότι ημαρτών σοι.
Κύριε, προσέκατε φυγών, διδάξον με του ποιήν το θέλημά σου, ότι σύ ο Θεός μου.
Ότι παρασύ πηγή ζωής, εν το φωτί σου ψώμεθα φως.
Παρατηνών το ελαιός σου της γήνος κουσίσε, Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Ναι, Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι,
γεννήν και και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν.
Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός,
Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος
αφέντες η δια του βαπτίσματος Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών της αθανάτου ζωής ηξιώθημε τη Αναστάση σου και ανυμνούντες κράζομεν ως ανά εν της υψίστης ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου.
Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και Άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε δεηθώμεν.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Υπέρ της ειρηνίας του σύμπαντος κόσμου, στα θείας των αιών των Θεού Εκκλησιών και της των πάντων ενός αίους του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For this holy temple, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
Υπέρ του Αρχιεπισκόπου ημών Αθαναήλ, του Τιμίου Πρεσβυτερίου της εν Χριστώ Διακονίας, πάντως του πλήρου και του λαού του Κυρίου
δεηθώμεν.
For the President of the United States, for those in civil authority, for the armed forces, for all the American nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Υπέρ της Ιεράς Μετροπόλεως Καινωνίας Ταύτης και Πάσης Πόλεως Μονής και Χωράς και των μυστικών των εναυτές του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε δεηθώμεν.
For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Υπερπλέοντον, οδηπορούντον, αεροπορούντον, ασούντον, καμνόντον, εκμαλώτον, και της σωτηρίας αυτών του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Αντιλαβούσον, ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της συγχωρητής.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Σπαναγίας ακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξα δεσποίησιμον Θεοτόκου και Αϊ Πάρθενου Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντε σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθώ. Ότι πρέπει εσύ πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκυνήσεις το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματι νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Ηγάπησα ότι σ' ακούσετε Κυρίως της φωνής της δεησεώς μου.
Τες πρεσβείες της Θεοτόκου σώτε ψώσον ημάς.
Περιέσχομεν οδύνες θανάτου κινδυνιάδου ευρώσαν με.
Through the intercessions of the Θεοτόκος save us.
Θλίψην και οδύνη ευρών και το όνομα Κυρίου επικάλεσαμεν.
Τις πρεσβείες της Θεοτόκου σώτε σώσον ημάς.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thine is the dominion, thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Επίστευσα δύο ελάλησα. Εγώ δε ταπεινώ την σφόδρα.
Σώσον ημάς Κύριε Θεού, ο επιπόδων ο καθεστής, σαν εντάσει αλληλουρία.
Τι ανταποδώσω το Κυρίο, περί πάντων ον αντεπέδω και μη.
Σώσον ημάς Κύριε Θεού, ο επιπόδων ο καθεστής, ψάλλοντας η αλληλουία.
Ποτήριον σωτηρίου λείψομαι και το όνομα Κυρίου επικαλέσομαι.
Σώσον ημάς Κύριε Θεού, ο επιπόλων ο καθεστής, ψάλλοντας η αλληλουία. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Άγιο Πνεύματι, και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ο μονογενής Υιός και Λόγος του Θεού, αθάνατος υπάρχων και κατεδεξαμένος δια την ημετέραν σωτηρίαν, σαρκωθήνε της Αγίας Θεοτόκου και Άγι Παρθένου Μαρίας ατρέτος εν ανθρωπίσας, σταυρωθήσε Χριστέ ο Θεός, θάνατο θάνατον πατήσας. Ίσον της Αγίας Τριάδος η δόξα ζωμένος Πατρί και το Άγιο Πνεύματι.
Έτσι και την ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν. Αντιλαβούς όσων ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός τη συγχωρητή. Παναγία Σακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξα δεσμίσιμον Θεοτόκου και Άι Πάρθενο Μαριάς, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσετε σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστού του Θεού παραθωμέθω. Ότι αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπωμεν, το Πατρί και του Υιό και του Αγίου Πνεύματι νυν και Άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Εξομολογήστε το Κύριο ότι αγαθός, ότι στον αιώνα του έλεος ασού, την κοινήν Ανάσταση πρώτου σου πάθους πιστούμενος, εκ νεκρών ηγείρας τον Λάζαρον Χριστέ ο Θεός, ούθεν και ημίσος υπέδες
κατής νίκης σύμβολα φέροντες, συν τον νικητή του θανάτου. Ουσανά εν της υψής της, ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος, εν ονόματι Κυρίου.
Ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου Θεός Κύριος και πέφανεν ημίν σώσον ημάς ιε Θεού ο επί πόλων ου καθεστή.
Ωσανά εν της υψής της, ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου.
Την κοινήν Ανάστασιν πρώτου σου πάθους πιστούμενος, εκ νεκρών ηγυράς το Λάζαρον Χριστέ ο Θεός. Όθεν και ημείς ως υπέδες, τα συνήκη συμβόλαν φέροντες, σύ τον νικητή του θανάτου βόμεν, ωσανά εν της υψής της, ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος, εν ονόματι Κυρίου.
Υπά τον δίκος αρών ότι αγαθός, ότι στον αιώνα το έλεος αυτού συνταφέντες
δια τους πατήματος Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών σε θανάτους ζωής ηξιώθημε η Αναστάσιση και ανημνούν και σκλάζονται ωσανά εν της υψής της, ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος, εν ονόματι Κυρίου.
Εν σημείτερο ακριβώς, διεσώθη το κατοικών, λαβούσα γάρ των σταυρών, οικολούθησα στο Χριστό και πράττουσα εδίδασκε υπερουράνε σαρκός. Παρέρχεται γάρ επιμελήστε δε ψυχή πράγματος αθανάτους. Διότι με τα άγγελων συναγάτη ως Θεία Μαρία το πνεύμα σου.
Στον Λάζαρο Χριστέ ο Θεός, ο δελκέιν αμήν σώσει Χριστέ ο Θεός,
των αγγέλων στην ένεση και των παιδών αλήμνηση, προς εξοβόντος ευλογημένος ή ο ερχόμενος, που να δάμανα καλέσαστε.
Let us pray to the Lord. O God, and holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
O holy God, rest among thy saints, and are glorified by the cherubim, and praised by the seraphim, by the thrice holy voice. Worship by all the hosts of heaven, thou hast come out all things out of nothingness into being, thou hast created man in thine own image and likeness, hast adorned him with all thy favors, thou who givest to the supplicant wisdom and prudence. Did not neglect the sinner, but hast set forth the way of repentance and of salvation. Thou hast accounted us then, humble and worthy servants, worthy to stand at this time before the glory of thy holy altar, to bring to thee adoration and praise. Do thou, Master, accept me from the mouth of the sinner to praise holy him. Visit us in the righteousness, forgive us of all transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship thee in holiness all the days of our life. Through the intercession of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints, who from the beginning of time have pleased thee, for thou art holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου, εξομολογήστε το Κυρίο ότι αγαθός εις τον αιώνα του έλεος αυτού.
Σοφία.
Ως Φιλιππησίους επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Προσκομέν.
Αδελφοί, χαίρετε εν Κυρίω πάντοτε, πάλι νερό χαίρετε, το επί οικές ημών γνωστήσω το πάσιν ανθρώπις. Ο Κύριος εγγύς μηδέν με ρημνάτε, αλλά εν παντή την προσευχή και την θέση με τα ευχαριστία στα αιτήματα ημών γνωριζέστο. Προς τον Θεόν και εις ειρήνην του Θεού, υπερέχουσα πάντα ανούν, φρουρίσει τας καρδίας ημών και τα νοήματα ημών εν Χριστώ Ιησού. Το λοιπόν, αδελφοί, όσα εστίνα αληθή, όσα σεμνά, όσα δίκαια, όσα αγνά, όσα προσκυλή, όσα έθιμα, εις την αρετήν και εις της έπαινος, ταύτα λογίζεστε, α και αμάθετε και παραλάβετε και ακούσατε και είδετε εν ημί, ταύτα προάσετε ο Θεός, εις ειρήνης έστε με θυμό.
Let us attend.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his mercy endures forever.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let all men know your forbearance. The Lord is at hand. Have no anxiety about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, do. And the God of peace will be with you.
Peace be with you, the reader. Ακούσμεν του Αγίου Ευαγγελίου ειρήνη πάση
και το πνεύμα της
εκ του κατά Ιωάννην Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα σήμερον του Πάσχα ήρθεν ο Ιησούς εις Βηθανίαν, όπου ειν Λάζαρος ο τεθνικός ον ήερεν εκ νεκρών, επίησαν ουν αυτό δείπνον εκεί, και η Μάρθα διηγώνει, ο δε Λάζαρος εις ειν τον ανεκειμένον συν αυτό, ιούν Μαρία λαβούσα λίτραν μύρου νάρδου, πιστικής πολιτήμου, ήλυψε τους πόδες του Ιησού και ξέμαξε τη στριξήν αυτής του πόδες αυτού. Ειν δε οικίαν επληρώθη, εκ της οσμής του μύρου, λέγει ουν εις εκ των μαθητών αυτού, Ιούδας Σίμωνος Ισκαριώτης, ο μέλλον αυτών παρηδιδώνε, διατί τούτο των μύρων ουκ επράκθη 300 διναρίων και δόθη φτωχής. Είπε δε τούτο, ουκ ότι περί των πτωχών έμελεν αυτό, αλλά ότι κλέπτης ειν και το γλωσσόκομον είχε και βαλόμενα, εβάσταξεν. Είπε ουν ο Ιησούς, άφες αυτήν εις την ημέραν
του εν τε φιασμού μου τετήρηκεν αυτό. Τους φτωχούς γαρ πάντοτε έχετε με Θεαυτόν, εμέ δε ου πάντοτε έχετε. Έγνω ουν όκλος πολλής εκ των Ιουδαίων ότι εκεί έστι και ήρθον ουδία των Ιησούν μόνον, αλ είναι κο των Λάζαρον είδωσιν, ον ήγηρεν εκ νεκρών. Ευουλεύσαντο, δε οι αρχιερείς είναι και των Λάζαρον αποκτήνωσιν, ότι πολλοί δι' αυτών υπήγον των Ιουδαίων και πίστευον εις τον Ιησούν. Τι επαύριον όκλος πολλής, ο ερθόν εις την εορτήν ακούσαντες ότι έρχεται ο Ιησούς εις Ιεροσόλυμα, έλευοντα βάγια των Φινίκων και εξήλθον εις υπάντησιν αυτό και έκραξον «Οσανά ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου, βασιλεύς του Ισραήλ». Εύρον δε ο Ιησούς, ον Άριον εκάθισεν επ αυτό, καθώς έστι γεγραμμένον μη φοβού θύγατερ Σιών, ιδού ο βασιλεύς σου έρχεται καθήμενος επί πόλου όνου. Ταύτα δε ουκ έγνωσαν οι μαθητέ αυτού το πρώτον, αλ ότε εδοξάσθη ο Ιησούς, τότε εμνίσθησαν ότι ταύτα είναι επ αυτό γεγραμμένα και ταύτα επίησαν αυτό. Εμαρτύρι ουν ο όχλος, ο όν μεταυτού, ότε τον Λάζαρον εφώνησεν εκ του μνημείου και ήγαινεν αυτόν εκ νεκρών. Δια τούτο και πίντησεν αυτού όκλο. Ότι οίκουσαν αυτό και τούτο αυτόν πεποίκαινε το σημείο. Reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John. Let us attend. 6 days before Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. There they made him a supper. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at table with him. Mary took a pound of costly ointment of pure nard, and anointed the feet of Jesus and wiped his feet with her hair, and the house was filled with the fragrance of the ointment. But Judas Iscariot, one of the disciples, he who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this ointment not sold for 300 denarii and given to the poor?" This he said not that he cared so much for the poor, but because he was a thief. And as he had the money box, he used to take what was put into it. Jesus said, "Let her alone, let her keep it for the day of my burial. The poor you always have with you, but you do not always have me." When the great crowd of the Jews learned that he was there, they came not only on account of Jesus, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priests planned to put Lazarus also to death, because on account of him, many of the Jews were going away and believing in Jesus. The next day, a great crowd who had come to the feast heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, crying, "Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, even the King of Israel." And Jesus found a young donkey and sat upon it. As it is written, "Fear not, daughter of Zion, behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt." His disciples did not understand this at first, but when Jesus was later glorified, when they remembered that this had been written of him and had been done to him. The crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead also bore witness. The reason why the crowd went to meet him was that they heard he had done this sign. Grant that being ever protected by thy power to thee, we may ascribe glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Desires of the pleasures of the flesh is worthy to reproach, or draw near to serve thee as great and awesome and without a dream. Always yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind, thou didst unchangeably and immutably become man and serve as our high priest and Lord of all, is committed to us the celebration of the liturgical and bloodless sacrifice. Lord, born on the throne of the cherubim and our Lord of the seraphim and King of Israel, who alone art holy, rest among thy saints. Wherefore implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant, cleanse my soul and my heart from an evil conscience. Enable me by the power of the Holy Spirit, bless with the grace of the priesthood, to stand before this, thy holy altar, and consecrate thy holy and immaculate body and precious blood. For to thee I come bowing, bowing my head, and beseech thee, turn not thy face away from me, neither reject from among thy children. Make me worthy to serve thee. For thou art the offered, accept, distributed of Christ our God, and to describe glory. Together, eternal Father, life, life, and spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Eat thy hero, be my supposed when used, and the spirit of the other, put the sign in.
Thank you. Πάντων ημών και πάντων των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών. Μνηστή Κύριος ο Θεός, εν τη βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νυν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. May the Lord our God remember us all in his heavenly kingdom. Now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Πληρώσομεν την δέησιν ημών το Κυρίο.
Κύριε ελέησον.
With these precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Αντιλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός, τη συγχωρείτε. This holy day, that it may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. For the forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. For things that are good and profitable unto our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord. Τον υπόλοιπον χρόνον της ζωής ημών εν ειρήνη και μετανοία εκτελέσε παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθο. The end of our lives may be Christian, without pain, blameless and peaceful, and for a good account at the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. Commemorating our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. Διατονικτήν μόνον του μόνου Ιανού σου Υιομέθου, ευλογητό εσύ, συν το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Peace be with you. Let us love
one another, that with one mouth we may confess.
Pater aion,
Christos en meso imonin cesti cestem. Αστήρας εν σοφία προσκομέν.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεό, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητήν ουρανού και γης, ορατών δε πάντων και οράτων.
Και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησούν Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού τον μονογενή, τον εκ του Πατρός εν ηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων.
Πώς εκ ποτός, Θεόν αληθινών εκ Θεού αληθινού,
γεννηθέντα, πιθέντα, ομοούσιον το πατρίδιο, το πάντα γένετο, τον ημάς τους ανθρώπους, δια την ημιτέραν σωτηρία,
κατελθόντα εκ των ουρανών, και σαρκωθέντα εκ πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας παρθένων και ανθρωπίσαντα. Σταυρωθένετε υπέρ ημών, επί ποδίου πιλάτου, και παθώντα και τα φέντα, και αναστάντα την τρίτη ημέρα κατσκαφάς. Και ανελθόντα εις τους ουρανούς και κατεζόμενον εκ δεξιών του Πατρός και πάλι ερχόμενο με τα δόξης, κρίνε ζώντας και νεκρούς, ούτης βασιλείας ούτ και στο τέλος. Και εις το Πνεύμα το Άγιον, το Κύριον, το Ζωοποιόν, το εκ του Πατρός εκπορευόμενο, το Συμπατρί και Υιός συμπροσκυνούμενο και συνδοξαζόμενο, το λαλήσαν διά των προφητών. Εις μίαν Αγίαν, Καθολικήν και Αποστολικήν Εκκλησία, ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφης αμαρτιών,
προς το Ανάσταση νεκρών
και ζωήν του μέλλοντος αιώνος.
Αμήν.
I believe in
one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, in one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Στομεν καλός, στομεν με το φόβο, προσκομεν την Αγίαν αναφοράν εν ειρήνη προσφέρειν.
Ελέον ειρήνης της
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you
all.
Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the
Lord.
Τον επινίκιον ύμνον άδοντα, βούντα και κραγώντα και λέγοντα, blessed powers, our Master who loves mankind, we also cry in all the life. We have been come to the rules of expectation, resurrected, and betrayed, or rather surrender himself for the life of the world. Having taken bread in his holy and immaculate and blameless hands, and every prayer of strength, sanctified and broken, he gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying,
το σώμα του επέριμον γλώμενον εις άφησιν αμαρτιών. Take, eat, this is my body, which for you is broken unto remission of sins. Likewise, the cup after the supper, saying,
Δεξ αυτού πάντες τούτο έστι το αίμα μου το της καινής διαθήκης το επερημών και πελών ευκοινόμενον εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών. Drink from it ye all. This is my blood of the New Testament, which for you and for many is shed unto remission of sins. Therefore, remembering this command of our Savior, and all that he endured for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, and the third day, the ascension into heaven, the seat at the right hand, the second and glorious coming again.
Si prosferomen kada panda ke dia panda. Rational and bloodless worship. And we beseech thee and pray and supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ, and that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ, changing them by the descent of the Holy Spirit. So that they may be to those who receive them for the purification of the soul and for the remission of sins, for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, and for the boldness to approach thee, neither unto judgment nor unto condemnation. Again, we offer unto thee this reasonable worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith.
Ξηλέτος της Παναγίας Ακράντου, υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσποίησιμον Θεοτόκου και αϊπαρθένου Μαρίας.
Yeah.
Ιησούς Χριστός, τη Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου ημών Αθαναήλ, ον χάρισε της Αγίας Εκκλησίας εν ειρήνης, ον εν ημονία μου κομερεύοντα και ορθοτομούντα των λόγων της εις αληθείας, και ον έχαστος κατά διάνοιαν έχει και πάντων και πάσων. Grant us that with one mouth and one heart we may glorify and praise thine all-honorable and majestic name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. In the mercies of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For these precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. That our merciful gift, who has received them on his holy and celestial and invisible altar, unto a scent of spiritual fragrance, may send down upon us divine grace, the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Την ενότητα της πίστεως και την κοινωνία του Αγίου Πνεύματος ετισάμενοι αυτούς και αλληλούς και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστό το Θεό, παραθώμεθα. Και καταξίωσον ημάς Δέσποτε με την παρησία σα κατά Κρήτος τολμάν επικαλείστε σε τον επουράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα και λέγειν. Πάτερ ημών, ο εν της ουρανής, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης, τον άρτον ημών των επιούσιων, δώσε μην σήμερον και άφησε μην τα αφιλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν τσε φιλέτης ημών, και εμείς εν έγκυση μας πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσε εμάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Ειρήνη πάση. Κεφαλάσιμον το Κύριο κλείνομεν. Through the grace and mercy and love for mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all-holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Προσκομεν, let us attend τα Αγία της Αγίας, the holy gifts unto the holy. εδωφού δεθέω πίστεως και αγάπης προσέρθετε.
Everlasting. Servant of God, for the mission of our sins, of our life everlasting. Agni dhuli dhuthayum, samsamadhyon kezhuin, yanyan amin. Servant of God, for the mission of our sins, of our life everlasting. Agni dhuli dhuthayum, Savisimation, Kesuin, Union, Amin. Servant of God. Yet our Savasis, the mission of the Saint of the Life Everlasting. Servant of God. The Life Everlasting. Servant of God. For the mission of our sins of the Life Everlasting. Servant of God, for the mission of our sins, of our life everlasting. Amen. Servant of God, for the mission of our sins, of our life everlasting. Servant of God. Life everlasting.
Alos soli. Αγίους του Θεού,
servant of God, Eleni has come in for the mission of the sins of the life of the last
servant of God,
the mission of the sins of the life of the last servant of God, the mission of the sins of the life of the last servant of God. Servant of God, mission of the sins of the life of the last. Servant of God, mission of the sins of the life of the last. Servant of God.
Amen.
Servant of God, mission of the sins of the life everlasting. Servant of God, mission of the sins of the life everlasting. Servant of God. Servant of God, Panagiotis, the mission of the Center for Life Everlasting. Medalavani Idulia to Theu, Irini, Sapsamation, Jesuin, Hirion, Amin. Servant of God, the mission of the Center for Life Everlasting. Idulus to Theu. Σαμπσιματιόν και ζουίν ιόνιον ανήν. Servant of God, is coming for the mission of the sins of the life of the last. Servant of God, Βασιλίκη, is coming for the mission of the sins of the life of the last. Servant of God, for the mission of her sins of her life everlasting. Servant of God, is commanded for the mission of her sins of her life everlasting. Servant of God, Constantina, is commanded for the mission of her sins of her life everlasting. Servant of God, come closer. That's it. For the mission of her sin, of her life everlasting. Servant of God,
everlasting. Servant of God. Everlasting. Servant of God, Constantinos. For the mission of the center for life. Servant of God. Center for life everlasting. Servant of God, 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 what in you is communion for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God. Servant of God, for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, let's come here for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, servant of God, Dimitrios, has committed the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Dimitrios, has committed the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Dimitrios, has committed the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, servant of God, Ioannis is commune for the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Evangelos is commune for the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Anthula is commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Andreas is commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, is commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Alexander. Commune for the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, for life everlasting. And you do it to Theo. Ekaterini, Samson Matheon, Kezuin, Eunion, Amin. Servant of God, commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Ioanna is commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God,
everlasting.
Servant of God,
for the remission of our sins, for life everlasting.
Servant of God,
for life everlasting.
Servant of God,
for the remission of our sins, for life everlasting.
Servant of God.
Servant of God.
Servant of God.
Servant of God.
For the mission of his sins, for life everlasting.
Servant of God.
For the mission of his sins, for life everlasting.
Servant of God.
For the mission of his sins, for life everlasting.
Servant of God.
For the mission of our sins, for life everlasting.
Servant of God.
For the mission of our sins, for life everlasting.
Μετρουβάνιε ο δούλος του Θεού, Βασίλειος, εις άμεσα σημαντιών και ζωήν, αιώνιον. Αμήν. Μετρουβάνιε οι δούλοι του Θεού, Ελένη, εις άμεσα σημαντιών και ζωήν, Union. Amen.
So is on the Theos to know and so cave loyis on the inclinomia and so. Πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving, and awesome mysteries of Christ. Worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Having asked the Lord that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Οδησίωειος μας ημών και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπωμεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Εν εν ίνι προέλθουμεν του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν.
Κύριεσον, 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 Πατέρα Ιε, ευλόγη.
blesses those and bless thee and sanctify those who put their trust in thee, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Protect the whole body of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy temple. Do thou glorify them by the divine power and forsake not us who set our hope in thee. Grant peace to the world, to the churches, to the priests, to the civil authorities, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For all good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And to thee we ascribe glory and thanksgiving and worship, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from henceforth and forevermore.
Κινήν Αναστάσιν πρώτους ο πάθους πιστούμενος εκ νεκρών υγείας των Λάζαρων Χριστέ ο Θεός όθεν και ημίσος υπέδες τα της νίκης σύμβολα φέροντες ψη τον νικητή του θανάτου ανάντης υψίστης ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου.
Του Κυρίου δεηθόμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Κύριε ο Θεός ημών ο καθήμενος επί των Χερουβήμ και εξεγείρας την δυναστείαν και ποστήλας των μονογενή σου Υιόν, των Κύριων ημών Ιησούν Χριστόν. Είναι σώσει τον κόσμον διά του Σταυρού, της Ταφής και της Αναστάσεως αυτού, ου παραγενωμένου εν Ιερουσαλήμ επί το κούσιον πάθος, ο λαός ο καθήμενος εν σκότη και σκιά θανάτου, λαβώντας τα της νίκης σύμβολα τους κλάδους των δέντρων, και ευλόγησον τα βάλια των φοινίκων, την Ανάστασιν προεμήνησαν. Αυτός δέσποτα και εμάς, τους καταμίμησιν εκείνων και προεορτίου, ταύτη ημέρα βάλια και κλάδους δέντρων, εν χερσί φέροντας, διατήρησον ως εκείνοι οι όκλοι και οι παιδες και ως ανά, σύ προσφέροντας διαφύλαξον, όπως εν και οδές πνευματικές καταξιωθόμεν και ζωπιό του ημέρου Αναστάσιος εν Χριστώ Ιησού του Κυρίου μεθού ευλογητώσει σύντο Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύματι νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord our God, enthroned above the cherubim, you have stirred up your power and sent your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to redeem the world through his cross, his burial, and his resurrection. When he came to Jerusalem to show voluntary passion, the people living in darkness and the shadow of death, taking up symbols of victory, boughs of trees and palm branches, foretold the resurrection. Master, as we too imitating them, carrying palms and branches on this eve of the Pentecost, watch over us. And as we offer you, Osana, like the multitudes and the children, safeguard us. Bless now these palms, so that in hymns and spiritual songs we too may worthily witness and the life-giving resurrection on the third day in Christ Jesus our Lord, with whom you are blessed together with your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. To give ear they thought men.
Ευλογία Κύριου και Λέως αυτού εθιβημάστη αυτού Θεία χάρη την και φιλανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Δόξα Σύ ο Θεός ελπίσιμον Κύριε δόξα Σύ.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
Ο εν πόλου όνου καθεστήνε καταδεξάμενος διά την ημών σωτηρίαν, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός ο Λυθρός Θεός ημών, τες πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και Πανομόμου Αγίας αυτού Μητρός, δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Εζώπιου Σταυρού, προστασίας του Τιμίου Παρανίων Δράμιων Σωμάτων, ηκεσίας του Τιμίου ενδόξου προφήτου Προδρόμου και Βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων ενδόξων και πανεφήμων Αποστόλων, των Αγίης Πατέρων ημών μεγάλων ηχών και μικρών δασκάλων, των Αγίης Πατρός ημών Ιωάννου Αρχιεπισκόπου Κωνσταντινοπόλεως του Χρυσοστόμου, των Αγίων ενδόξων και καλλινίκων μαρτύρων των Οσίων και Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατώνων Ιωακήμ και Άνιης, εν τη λαμπράν και ένδοξον πανήγυριν της εις Ιερουσαλήμ, εισόδου του Κυρίου ημών Ιησού Χριστού εορτάζομεν και πάντων των Αγίων, ελέησε και σώσε ημάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελέημον Θεός. Τιφούν των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς. Η Αγία Τριάστη φυλάξε πάντες ημάς, ημέρα σας και χρόνια σας πολλά.
Thank you.
Good morning. And chronia pola to everyone on this beautiful day of Palm Sunday. A few announcements, and they all pertain, of course, to the upcoming Holy Week and the schedule. The schedule you'll find inside of the weekly bulletin, which, of course, is available at the Pangadi and, of course, online at our website. So it lists the services, the times, the days, and we ask that you look at those times and to schedule as many services as you're able to attend during the coming week. Of significant importance is the initial visitation of our newly assigned Metropolitan of Chicago, Metropolitan Nathaniel. He will be attending our service on Holy Tuesday evening, and we certainly believe that it would be in our, probably in so that you have a chance to be able to meet and greet our Metropolitan, who is here only a week. He will be with us for services on this evening. There will be a coffee hour afterwards. Usually the Metropolitan for the last 40 plus years has always attended on the 12 Gospels on Good Thursday evening, Holy Thursday evening. However, the schedule has been changed a little bit, and this Metropolitan is attending on Tuesday evening, therefore allowing our people to be able to attend, but also with the service ending much earlier than the Thursday night evening service, it will give all of us a chance to be able to welcome Metropolitan Nathaniel to the Chicago area. We encourage the families. We know it's a weeknight, but the service will be ending probably about 8:30. So if we're able to bring our families, our children, I'm sure His Eminence would be pleased to see them as well in attendance. So we bring that to your attention, that our Metropolitan will be visiting on Tuesday evening, and the rest of the services are listed in your weekly bulletin. This day of Palm Sunday is, we also have our traditional fish luncheon down in Plato Hall, and that will happen immediately following the distribution of the palms and the andidro. Those of you that have made reservations, and even those who have not, there is some room available downstairs. If you would like to come downstairs for the luncheon, you certainly are welcome to do so. We're grateful to the donor who has donated, who has underwritten the luncheon. And this year's proceeds will not remain with the church. They will be going towards proceeds which has been designated, will benefit the Orthodox mission in Kenya under Bishop Athanasios of Kisumu and Western Kenya. He is, I've had the pleasure of meeting him. He was here for the enthronement. He is a dynamic young bishop, and he is serving in Kenya, and Orthodoxy is spreading there. He, as well as his diocese and the metropolis in Kenya, will benefit greatly from this donation from our parish, just like in many other parishes who are supporting this project as well. And of course, this evening we begin with our Nymphio services, and that service begins at 7 o'clock upstairs in the main church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. As we entered our beautiful church of Panagia this morning, we were immediately welcomed to this celebration of Palm Sunday. Of course, visually we see the palms, and today is a joyous occasion. As we remember the account of crowds of people who lined the streets of Jerusalem, as we were told in our Bible reading, where they welcomed what they believed was going to be their Messiah and the deliverer from the tyranny of the Romans. Many who witnessed Jesus riding into Jerusalem on that first Palm Sunday were filled with hope. They were filled with expectation. They had suffered many, many, many years, hundreds of years, and had long waited for a king to emerge from the ranks who would bring victory and freedom to them on this earth. So they had come out to see what they thought was going to be this new religious leader of a new religious movement, and quite possibly what they hoped to be the Messiah that they had been promised. The people of Jerusalem, these Jews, had heard amazing stories about this man. Stories that we listen to in the gospel readings. Stories about Jesus feeding thousands of people with simply two fish and five loaves of bread. They also heard about his ability to heal people, and even about his raising of Lazarus from the dead. Could this be? Could this possibly be the one that they had been long waiting for? But how did this Messiah enter the great city of Jerusalem on this auspicious day? Our Bible reading told us. On a donkey, not on a stallion, not accompanied by a legion of soldiers, and he was definitely not greeted by the dignitaries of the city. He entered the city on a simple donkey colt. But why? Why would he not make his entrance as a king and as a Messiah? Very simple. It was to fulfill the Old Testament prophecy by the prophet Zechariah, who wrote many centuries before that one day the Messiah would arrive on a donkey. And these are the words that Zechariah wrote in his book in the Old Testament, if you want to go home and check it. In chapter 9, verse 9, where he wrote, "Rejoice greatly, daughter Zion. Shout, daughter Jerusalem. See, your king comes to you righteous and victorious, lowly and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey." And on this day of Palm Sunday, and on that glorious day when Christ entered Jerusalem, that's exactly what happened. As the story tells us, as they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethany at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and just as you enter it, you will find a colt tied there, which no one has ever ridden before. Untie it and bring it here to me. And if anyone asks you where you are going and what you are doing, say the Lord needs it, and we'll send it back there shortly when we're finished." And the two disciples did what Jesus commanded them, and went and found a colt outside in the street, tied at a doorway. And they untied it. And some of the people standing there asked, just as Jesus had predicted would happen, they asked, "What are you doing untying that colt?" And they answered as Jesus had told them to, and the people allowed them to take the colt. When they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks over it, he sat on it. And as we heard in the gospel reading this morning, many people spread their cloaks on the ground, while others spread branches of palms that they had cut in the fields. Those who were ahead and those who followed shouted, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." My dear friends, it is this gospel reading, it is one of the most beautiful stories that we find in our Bible, because it is a story of great humility. And while all of this was happening, on the other side of the city of Jerusalem, Pontius Pilate was entering the city on a great stallion, while Jesus was riding into the city on a young and unbroken donkey. Pilate was surrounded by a security force of Roman soldiers bearing swords and shields and heavy armor. Jesus entered the city surrounded by unarmed peasants waving palm branches, the symbol of peace. Pilate's soldiers sneered when they saw them. Jesus' followers sang, "Hosanna, blessed he is he who comes in the name of the Lord." And we see no greater contrast than this: the kingdom of this world and the kingdom of God. Brute force versus gentle peace. And yet, more than 2,000 years later, the only reason we ever hear in our church services the name Pontius Pilate is that each time we recite our Pistevo, the Nicene Creed in our divine liturgy, we say this about Christ: he suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, and was buried. Ultimately, gentle peace won out over brute force, as it will one day when the final chapter of humanity is written and the end of the world is realized. True humility is a beautiful thing to see in any human being. When Jesus came to Jerusalem, there was no preparation made for his coming. There was no royal chariot, just a borrowed donkey to ride on. Jesus came with humility. Yet his message was crystal clear. He was announcing to the world that he was the Messiah. And this is why the religious authorities were stirred up with hatred towards him, because they were threatened. They knew Zechariah's prophecy of the Old Testament that I quoted from just a few moments ago was there right in front of their eyes. They knew that some of the people who were welcoming him that day in Jerusalem were hoping that he was the one who would deliver them. Not only was that a threat to the religious establishment, but they knew if Jesus gathered much of a following among the simple people, he would bring the might of Rome down upon them. And he was a threat to the established order. So the Jews couldn't stomach that. They couldn't tolerate that. And they plotted what to do with Jesus. And it probably could have been avoided, except for this day, for Palm Sunday. Someone once noted that the problem with palms is that once you cut the branches from the tree, they don't live very long. Similarly, the problem with Palm Sunday is that the excitement of the crowds didn't last very long either. And just a few short days later, when Good Friday came, many of the same voices who shouted "Hosanna" were shouting "Crucify him, crucify him." The crowd of people who cheered Jesus at the triumphal entry into Jerusalem soon turned into a mob that would later crucify him on a cross. Jesus rode into Jerusalem on a colt,
the foal of a donkey, signaling that he was the Messiah. And he set into motion events that he knew were irreversible. Some of the crowd who had sung his praises that morning would be the same persons who would participate in his execution just a few days later. Jesus, this humble man and loving man, who sought to bring only love and compassion into the world, would die how? The cruelest of deaths on the cross of Golgotha. A death he refused to avoid. And the most amazing thing, my dear friends, is that he did it for you and he did it for me. Sadly, there are a lot of people who feel that just because they were baptized many years ago, they have some God-given right that they're going to go to heaven. That they deserve God's grace poured out in Christ's passion, when most of us didn't even have a choice in our baptism. It was our parents. That sort of misguided thinking robs the cross of its power. The only way that we will ever feel the saving power of the cross is when we realize that we could never be worthy of Christ's sacrifice any more than that little donkey was when Jesus rode him into the city of Jerusalem. The grace of God is a gift that we should be eternally grateful for and seek to earn it each and every day. Jesus was a man of great humility. And when he rode into Jerusalem on a colt, the foal of a donkey, he set into motion, as I said, events that were irreversible. And they resulted in his death and his crucifixion. But here's the good news. As I said before, he did it for you and me. Greater love has no one than this, says John chapter 15, verse 13, than to lay down one's life for one's friends. We are Christ's friends, not because of any virtue that we have, but through his amazing love for all God's children. And that is what sent Jesus to the cross, his courage, his commitment, and his absolute compassion. Finally, on that first Palm Sunday, Jesus knew that he knew ahead of time. He knew that before the week was over, he would be carrying his own cross through the streets of Jerusalem. Only this time, there would be no cheering crowds that day. He knew what he had to do to fulfill God's will. He had to give his life for a dying world, and that's what he did. And so, beginning with this evening, we enter the most sacred and holy week on the Orthodox Christian calendar. Try something different this year. Prepare your heart and soul for the gift that Christ gave us by dying and resurrecting in order that we might be saved. Are you going to prepare your heart and soul for the resurrection of our Lord? Are you going to fight the good fight and run the good race, as the passage says in the pre-sanctified liturgies that we have been doing during Great Lent? Are you going to walk these last footsteps with Jesus so that he may know that you are grateful for the gift that lays before us? Our Lord continues to bless us abundantly. So let us not waste that gift. Let us use this Holy Week to cleanse ourselves to receive our Lord. So if you have not as yet caught fire, not as yet committed your soul to salvation, don't turn your head away. Don't tune out your mind or your ears or your soul, and don't close your eyes, because God's gift is right in front of you. Rather, open them up. Because Jesus wants you and he wants me. He wants us to open our hearts and souls to him who, through his sacrifice, we may have his gift of eternal life. Amen. As we do each Palm Sunday, we ask Our Lady's Philoptikos Society to come forward and to pass one special tray, which we don't do often in this church, a second tray. We ask them to come forward so that they may have a special collection to assist them in the decoration of the Epitaphios on Friday morning. So we ask for you to be as generous as you're able to. Thank you.
Thank you. flashlights necessary, right? Bring a little flashlight.